Hi, I'm Nick Harauz of Creative 111 here with Boris Effects to give you some tips and tricks to working with Sapphire inside of Adobe Premiere Pro. Today we're going to take a look at S Transition, and I've done a search under my Effects tab for S Transition. It's available under Sapphire Builder category. I'll take that transitional effect and apply it to an edit point on my timeline. Right away, I don't become overwhelmed by the default effect that it gives me, which is just a dissolve. But if I select the effect and press Shift-5 to reveal its parameters and effect controls, I can choose to load a preset. Loading a preset will give me a gateway into all of the presets available for the various transitions that ship with Sapphire. For instance, if I go here and choose to select one of the S_dissolve glow effects. Here I can see the preview over the middle of my footage and get a sense for how that works. And also then just choose an effect that I want to work with, such as super subtle glow. If I choose to load that into Premiere Pro, I can choose to see it over my glorious footage. On top of that, if I go back to load a preset, besides seeing just the individual transitions that ship with Sapphire in the presets, we've got builder effects. What these are is they use a transition as a base and they combine it with a cool Sapphire effect. Take a look at cool light leak. With that selected and me loading that into Premiere Pro, this effect combines a dissolve base mixed with the Sapphire light leak to give you a cool light leak transition over your footage. With the effect still selected on closer look, if we go to edit the effect, we enter the Sapphire Transition Builder, where we can see the dissolve base combined with the light leak. The very cool thing about this is that we can choose to change the base to the two main types of transitions, which are either dissolves or wipes, mixed with some other effects, which are a kind of a combination in some cases of dissolves or wipes, and choosing something such as dissolve glow, you can add effects on top to the from or to clip and mix that to create your own unique transitions for your project. And as a video editor, know that this is just going to be part of your job. Looking at the light leak parameters, know that someone has chosen to only publish certain parameters over to Premiere Pro for the editor to see. If I wanted to add additional ones, I could click on those effects and then they would have access to that, like saturation, inside of Premiere Pro. And be sure to click the link above to download a free trial of Sapphire and check this out for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all the Boris Effects products. I'm Nick Harauz. Thanks for watching.